We should maybe ask someone out that's near and dear to Marvelous 3's heart, because when we were just getting ramped up and getting started, and our song was like all over the radio, and all of a sudden we were out working as a real band and out doing it, and we're like, man, we gotta go tour, we gotta get in front of some people, and it would be really cool if we could get out, you know, maybe open it for somebody bigger, you know, so that we could, like, you know, maybe soak up some fans of theirs and just, like, maybe try to turn some people on. And the problem was, nobody wanted to take us out opening for them. I don't know, maybe we were just too fucking good. That's what we told ourselves. I don't know, it was kind of weird. It was 1998 or whatever, and we were wearing like skinny jeans and eyeliner, and I mean, that shit didn't like really catch on for another like 5 years. So I think people kind of looked at us weird because we weren't wearing like JNCOs and had dreadlocks and weird beards. So like, we were just like these little, you know, scrappy, skinny, spiky haired dudes out there playing power pop, and I know it really wasn't like fitting in or fashionable, but we had a song on the radio, and there was a guy who was a big fan of that song, and he loved our band so much, he said, I'm gonna take you guys out on tour, and we're gonna go everywhere, and you're gonna play in front of thousands of people a night. And it was one of the best times of our lives, and I give it up so hard for my brother Ed Roland in Collective Soul. Come on, here, for taking a chance on us and letting us come do our thing. Everybody, a warm welcome for Ed Roland.